Hey friends, welcome to the Organization Theory series. Today we are going to understand about the Administrative Management Theory by Henry Fayol, all you need to know. So let's start. First of all, we need to know who is Henry Fayol. Henry Fayol was a French person. He actually joined as an engineer in a mining firm in 1860 when he was just 19 years old. His aim was to develop a universal theory of management. Universal means a theory which is applicable in all types of organization, all sizes of organization, any and every organization, whether it's a profit, non-profit, big, small, charitable, or manufacturing, non-manufacturing, whatever the type of organization is. The theory given by Henry Fayol will be applicable to all as per Henry Fayol. This theory was given for the purpose of making the organizations efficient and effective. Fayol presented his total work in Administration Industrielle et Générale in 1916. Okay, so this was a brief introduction of Mr. Henry Fayol, who actually gave a breakthrough theory in the form of Administrative Management Theory. And this particular theory is actually considered as a universal theory which is applicable to all types of organization. Let me remind you, in the last video, we learned about the scientific management theory given by Taylor, F.W. Taylor, and which is more applicable, or which is in fact designed for the manufacturing concern. But this particular theory is designed for all types of organization. Okay, let's see what this theory is all about. In a nutshell, we can say that this theory says that every organization has six main activities. These activities are technical, commercial, managerial, physical. Among all these six activities, this activity, that is managerial activity, is the most important activity. This is the activity which determines the success of other five activities. Okay, and this activity consists of five functions, that is planning, organizing, commanding, coordinating, and controlling. He goes on to say that all these five functions can be performed effectively by following these 14 principles. So the whole theory of Henry Fayol can be summarized under six activities, five functions, and 14 principles. And all these things, they aim at making the organization efficient and effective. Okay, let us understand these things in detail. First of all, activities. As Fayol said that every organization has six main activities. The first activity is technical, which is the core activity or the organic activity which is related to what the organization actually do, that is production, manufacturing, or providing services. Second is commercial, that involves buying, selling, or exchange of goods and services. Then comes financial activity that every organization has to do, because finance is the lifeblood of business, and this activity includes utilization of finance, deciding, making decisions about the use of finance, procurement of finance, etc. Then comes security, that involves protection of personal and property. Accounting is bookkeeping, stock taking, cost, statistics, etc. Managerial, that is the most important activity according to Henry Fayol, and which consists of five functions. What are the functions in managerial activity? Planning. Planning involves deciding on goal, objective, then making strategy, then making plans for it. Organizing is particularly arranging everything for the execution of the plan or the execution of the strategy, or we can command, or we can say achievement of goal. So this is putting everything in order, place, human being, material, men, everything in order is covered in organizing activity. We are actually making arrangement, we are actually preparing for the work to be done. Commanding activity, in this commanding function, what we are doing, we are actually delegating, decentralizing, or we are just entrusting the work to the employee. We are telling the people what to do, when to do, how to do. This is commanding activity. Coordinating activity is assisting your individuals, your subordinates, your employees as and when they need. That means seeing whether the work is done properly or not and giving them assistance, providing them guidance whenever they need it. Controlling activity is particularly the activity in which the actual results are compared with the expected results. And then it is seen whether there are any variations or not. If variations are there. Then the reasons of the variations are being looked at and it is being considered whether such reasons were evident or there was any flaw in the plan itself, strategy itself, or there was something wrong with the implementation thing. And then all those things are considered while making the plan next time. So it is a kind of circle that goes on: planning, organizing, commanding, coordinating, controlling, and then again planning. Okay. So these five functions of managerial activity can be managed or performed in the most optimum or the best possible way by following the 14 principles given by Mr. Henry Fayol. Mr. Henry Fayol says that these 14 principles are universal. That means these principles can be applied in every organization whatsoever, without irrespective of its size or type. Okay. So let us understand each and every principle given by Mr. Henry Fayol. Division of work. It says that work should be divided, work should be delegated, work should be systematically divided so that every person in the organization knows what he or she has to do. So there is no confusion at all in the organization. Second is authority and responsibility. We have done this thing in the previous videos. Let me tell you once again that authority cannot go without responsibility, and responsibility cannot be given without authority. Authority and responsibility has to be in balance. Authority, if authority is greater than responsibility, then it leads to dictatorship. And if responsibility is greater to authority, then it is inefficiency. Because a person who is responsible for more things but has less power or authority in his hands will not be able to perform or implement things in the better way. So authority and responsibility are coexistence, and there has to be proper balance between authority and responsibility. Next is initiative. This is a very innovative, we can say, human side of this particular theory, in which Mr. Henry Fayol says that there should be proper provision for providing opportunity to the individual, to the employee, for initiative, so that employees can bring out their ideas, new ideas, and they can improve the organizations by their own skill, talent, etc. So there should be some scope in the organization for the employees' initiative. Fourth one is centralization, which actually focuses on concentration of power in few hands. It says that the authority must flow from the top, and also the decisions must flow from the top. And most of the decision-making power should actually get concentrated in the top level. Okay. The fifth one is unity of command. It says that every employee should have only one boss. That means an employee should be following the orders from one boss only. So that is like clarity in the organization, and fixation of accountability is possible. It is actually contradictory to the Taylor's technique of functional foremanship, where every individual has got 8 bosses. Sixth is unity of direction. It says that each and every person in the organization, each and every energy in the organization, each and every resource in the organization should be channelized towards one particular goal. That is one common goal. That means for which the organization has been formed, that purpose. So every employee should have only one goal, one direction. Okay. Now, stability of tenure. This actually focuses on retention of employees and minimizing the employee turnover. Because we know that more the employee turnover, greater will be the expenditure, greater the cost of recruitment, selection, induction, orientation, training, etc. Eighth one is discipline. Every organization is supposed to have some kind of discipline where the employee follows the rules of the organization. Ninth is remuneration. We all know that the classical thinkers treat human beings or the employees or the subordinates as rational economic man whose economic needs can be satisfied with fair remuneration or wages. So here also Henry Fayol says that wages has to be fair so that the employees are satisfied. And if the employees are satisfied, there will be auto goal congruency, and hence the organizational goal will be achieved. 10th is subordination of individual interest to general interest. This is a very idealistic approach given by Mr. Henry Fayol. Here he says that in any case, whenever there is a kind of goal congruency or the conflict of interest between, at any time in the organization when there is any case of goal conflict rather than goal congruency, case of goal conflict, where there is a conflict of interest between the individual and the organization, then individual should be like a sacrificer who will forego his own particular personal interest for the overall or bigger organizational goal. So this is very much idealistic, where the individual will subordinate his personal or personal interest, personal goal, etc., for the greater organizational goal. This goes for departments, subunits, etc. Hence, it is against the subunit goal internalization. We have done this thing in detail in the video on goal conflict. 11th is order. That means everything has to be systematic, everything has to be in order, everything in the organization should have some place, a particular place, specific place for everything. 12th is equity. It actually is getting more sympathetic towards the employee and to treat employee very fairly and impartially, as they should be equal pay for equal work, irrespective of the gender of the employee or any other thing. It is like equity. There should be equity in the organization. Every employee should be treated fairly and impartially. 13th is spirit de corps. That means spirit of cooperation, very easy to understand. 14th is scalar chain. Actually, this scalar chain is chain of superiors from the ultimate authority to the lowest rank. This shows us the path of communication, the passage through which any information travels in the organization. For example, if D has to communicate with A, then the communication will be like D to C, C to B, B to A, and then A to E. This makes conversation very orderly and systematic. And this also fixes the responsibility and accountability on the person who is sharing the information. And this helps in spreading humor. This actually prevents in spreading rumors or gossiping, etc. So this is a very systematic approach for the passage of information in the organization. But as you can see, that this particular way or passage or path or channel is a little lengthy, and therefore it may lead to delay in passing of information or delay in communication of things. And sometimes the delay may be so much that the things may become redundant. The information may become redundant because it is said that information delayed is information denied. So this is also a drawback of this particular chain. So we have done all the 14 principles of Mr. Henry Ford, and I hope you understood. Now let us understand the crux of Mr. Fayol theory. See, Mr. Fayol theory is a very structural theory. At that point of time when this theory was presented in 1916, the organizations were managed in a very haphazard manner, individualistic manner, and trial and error method kind of thinking was used. So this theory, when came in that time, it was very structural, which provided a systematic basis or systematic way of managing organizations. The lot of belief is being placed in principles. It is general. That means it is a universal theory which is applicable to everyone, every organization, and any organization. Efficiency, the focus is on efficiency and effectivity. Capable of adaptability. This is the most important line. Here is the capable of adaptability. This particular theory is capable of adaptability. These are not rigid set of rules. We'll go in detail in the coming slides. Okay. First of all, let us see critical appreciation of this theory. This theory ignores the human side of enterprise. As you know that all the classical thinkers are being criticized on this ground of ignoring the human side. But who are the neoclassical thinkers or behavioral thinkers? They say that this particular theory is very mechanical and too structural, losing the human touch. And as we can see in the principles like scalar chain, where there is a fixed passage or fixed line of communication, unity of command, that there can be only one boss to subordinate, no order from any other person, centralization, like concentration of power in few hands, and division of work, who has to do what. So these are very formal, systematic things. But some people who favor Henry Fayol, they say that Fayol considered the psychological needs of individual. We can see this in the principles like equity, where the employees have to be treated equally and fairly and impartially, initiative, and spirit de corps. Okay, so both sides of this thing. Next is prescriptive. There are two things. One is prescriptive theory, other is descriptive theory. Prescriptive theory is what should be done, what should be there, or these are like guidelines or setting, telling things what should be there, what should be done, etc. Descriptive theory is particularly with how the things are to be done. They tell us how this thing can be achieved. So various thinkers, they argue that Taylor's theory was a kind of descriptive theory which gave us the technique, the operational tools by which those principles like mental revolution or other things could be implemented in the organization. He gave us the techniques like the functions for management, motion study, work studies and different kind of studies, scientific recruitment and training, and the incremental wage plan, etc. But Mr. Fiol, he only gave us the principles to any kind of technique for the implementation of those principles. So he's being criticized on this ground. But again, his followers, as they say that scientific management theory was actually based on only management or manufacturing concerns. So it was quite easy for them to give the techniques. But as Mr. Fiol's theory is applicable universally to every organization, so there cannot be general techniques. There can be only general principles. So the freedom is given to the manager in order to come out with the operational tools according to the needs of their enterprise. So this is said that Fiol presented skeleton, that means principles, not the flesh, that is techniques. So flesh is to be provided by the organization as per its unique needs. Okay. Easily done. Next one is about the principles. Many thinkers like Herbert Simon, they say that these principles are merely proverbs or merely slogans. And Mr. Peter F. Drucker, he questioned the validity of even a slightly more complex organization than Mayor Fiol's mining firm. What he is saying that the principles given by Mr. Henry Fiol will not be applicable or will not be valid to an even slightly more complex organization. Okay. So, and again, Mr. Peter Drucker says this also, that it can't be applied to modern organizations which are like boundaryless, or system organizations which are relatively open, because these can't work on the basis of hierarchy. So universality, time universality of principle is not applicable. Mr. Peter Drucker says that the principles given by Mr. Henry Fiol cannot be applied in all time periods and even in all types of organizations, and if they are more complex than the Mr. Fiol's mining firm, etc. So what they are saying here, the principles like unity of command, centralization will lose their relevance with time. And like we can say, unity of command is not possible in project or metrics kind of organizational structure, etc. And he says that every organization has its own dynamics. So let's see what the followers of Mr. Fiol says here. They say that Mr. Peter F. Drucker, dear, these principles are not rules. Okay, so these are inductive principles, and Mr. Fiol never argued for the application of principles. Then how can you say that his principles are mere slogan, are mere proverbs? So guys, the followers of Mr. Fiol still stand by his side, saying that these principles are inductive, and the most important part they say is they are capable of adaptability. See, let us see what is this capability of adaptability. Let's understand. See, Mr. Fiol, actually, when he designed or devised this particular theory of universal applicability, then he kept some provision or some scope for flexibility. He himself gave the examples like these 14, he said, these 14 functional truths are principles but not rules. So they are not rigidly to be applied in every organization. Okay. Unity of direction should go along with unity of command. When you have one boss guiding one employee, and at the same time, all the employees should be guided by one direction or one common goal. So it is like saying that this unity of command should not be in contradiction with unity of direction. Okay. So all the every employee has got one boss or is being following the orders of one boss, but all the employees in the organization are following only one goal or one. And in the skill chain, as we have seen that this particular passage of the channel may leads to delaying information, etc. So he has provided another communication platform between the employees at the same level, or the managers at the same level, maybe in different organizations, in different departments or functions. They at the same level can communicate with each other using a gang plank or bridge. So in this also, he has provided a purposive violation of the hierarchy principle in the form of gang plank. Okay. Then again, there are two principles, centralization and initiative, which goes little contradictory, as centralization and focuses on concentration of more and more power, where decision-making power, whereas in initiative, we are leaving scope for the employees' initiative, employees' opportunity to provide input in new input in the organization, think of his own ideas, etc. So there has to be balance between the two. So he is considering the human factor also, as well as the organization's effective and efficiency. So Mr. Peter Drucker says that Fuel's functional organization is still the best way of designing structures of small businesses, particularly manufacturing one. So Peter Drucker is still stick on the thing that Mr. Fuel's patent theory is applicable to small businesses, less complex businesses, as well as not applicable to modern organizations, etc., etc. So this particular theory has got its pros as well as its cons. Particularly, this has been criticized also, and this has been appreciated also a lot by a lot many thinkers. And we all know that whatever the situation is, Mr. Fayol was the first person to come up with a universal theory of management, with a universal theory which is applicable to all kinds of organizations, with 14 universal principles and extremely useful principles, as well as 6 main activities of organization and 5 main functions of the managerial activity, etc. Important part of management. I hope you understood. And in the next video, we'll be doing the Weber's bureaucracy. And till then, stay healthy.